I'll divide、Japanese animation into three stages、based on narrative structure, how they developed a particular narrative. And、Japanese animation history usually considered to be, you know,、initiated by Astro Boy. Although Japanese people made animation even before the war, as for commercial animation, we could safely say it started with、Astro Boy in 1964. And it's important because it was also really successful in, you know, foreign countries. And、as for the first stage, many、TV programs, mostly TV programs based on manga. Manga was, you know, the dominant form of entertainment in post-war Japan. And many、early animations are just,、many TV、animations around this period were based on, you know, very famous manga. So, and also、in terms of style, in terms of their styles, they basically follow or try to incorporate some of the so-called classic Hollywood narratives. So, again, linear kind of goal-oriented characters. And mostly based on, you know,、print media, manga. And I would、delineate、some transformation. I would indicate a transformation around 1980. And with Mobile Suit Gundam, hugely successful program. So in the first stage, most of the programs are based on manga. So they are more or less faithful to the original story. Because, you know, if you betray the, you know, the original,You know, many fans, larger than the, you know,、animation audience, just upset about, you know, the transformations or changes, alterations. But at certain point, because of the prosperity of animation industry,、many studios started developing, you know, copyright contents. That means、stories.And、it was pioneered by some、company like Sunrise,、especially、with this particular program, Mobile Suit Gundam. So it's based on nothing, basically created for this particular, you know,、project. And、it was sponsored by、tie-in toy companies. So you sell、gadgets, robot, or, you know, models, and you get money.For making a movie,、making an animation, and animation will, you know, advertise the toys. So that's basically the idea. It somehow transformed、the direction、of adaptation from、the first stage from manga to animation. And because of the copyright holder now turned into、animation industry.、Animation industry created secondary creations, novelizations, or comic versions of the anime programs. But they still、follow kind of story,、linear, goal-oriented stories, but just the, you know, master narrative, someone who possesses the master narrative has changed from, you know, manga industry to animation industry. But,Around this period, especially towards the end of the 1980s, we saw really interesting changes in the media industry. And that's what I would call anime culture. This is almost like the birth of anime culture. By anime culture, I would say more like excess, culture based on excess, culture not based on traditional Hollywood style, linear, goal-oriented narrative style. And I'm going to discuss about this particular narrative strategies、of the anime culture、shortly. But、please keep in mind,、it is usually marked by Tenchi Muyo.And、here, what I should、emphasize is something like story consumption.、in terms of traditional animation programs in the first stage and the second stage, there is a narrative, grand narrative, a linear, goal-oriented narrative. And based on that grand narrative, you will create secondary creations or novelization or manga version. But interestingly, around 1980s, because of the consumption and advertisement industries, there was really interesting strategies for marketing. And one of the marketing is Bikkuriman Choco. I'm not, anyone knows Bikkuriman Choco? I'm not sure it may have, you know, transported to the United States. Maybe never. Bikkuriman Choco is a kind of a trading card, but it's kind of a sticker. You purchase some chocolate and there is a sticker inside, and you will basically, you know, collect those stickers. And behind each sticker, basically the sticker is some character. Behind the sticker, there is a small narrative, small story about some rumor in the world, Bikkuriman world. And by purchasing those, you know, stickers, basically you create the grand narrative or the world those characters live. And in order to collect all the stickers, you know, you have to pay significant amount of money, or you have to exchange, you know, those stickers with your friend. And all the, in order to get all the, you know, characters, you have to all total 272 stickers, so it takes almost forever. So I had, you know, only several people achieved, you know, getting all the stickers, you know, and also several stickers are, you know, secret stickers, never produced, just only produced two copies or not. So that kind of, you know, settings. It's interesting strategy because it's different from, for example, baseball card. That baseball cards that's based on someone's fame, already established grand narrative, and baseball card should be supplementing someone's fame or making that, you know, grand narrative more famous. Or, you know, some Kamen Rider, Masked Rider series, that there is a grand narrative of Masked Rider, and a successful merchandise was in fact, you know, stickers for, you know, that Masked Rider. But again, the motive of the sticker is more like, you know, supporting the popularity of the grand narrative of Masked Rider. But this is different, because this is basically participatory culture through which you have to create the grand narrative. Or we are not even sure there is a so-called quote-unquote grand narrative, because it's kind of the producer never presented a clearly delineated grand narrative. So they hinted so many possibilities about the grand narrative behind the small narrative, small local narrative, but you are never sure about the, you know, existence of the actual grand narrative. But at least because of the lack of that, you know, clear delineation, and also the hints that there should be some grand narrative behind the small narratives, you are compelled to spend more in order to boost your desire to collect everything. So it's interesting because the grand narrative is never presented clearly. It's possible if you understand the grand narrative, or if you reassembled grand narrative, it's possible that you can create a small narrative, your own small narrative, that may not necessarily be a copy. Because you can't say actually your version is particularly a copy, because, you know, all the narratives are theoretically just a copy of, you know, supposedly grand narrative behind this, you know, project. And that increasingly boosted a kind of consumer participation in the process of consuming stories and narratives.